this man is tired. This man wants to leave you now.
That's true. That's what I told myself what I will do today. Even I told her.
You told her?
Yeah, I told her. That today I will not go back home.
She doesn't have the truth.
Yeah, she doesn't have the truth. She's always lying.
That's why you're tired.
Yeah. I tried to speak to her. It's almost 6 months now.
And sometimes when you speak with her, she's like, she's not hearing you.
It's true. It's true.
She knows how to ignore you.
It's true. It's true, man of God. It's true.
You're
I'm tired.
When you're busy here talking, she looks
She just leave, yeah.
And sometimes she stood up and she left.
Yeah. Last week, Saturday, I was involved in a car accident. I could not walk. I was using some crutches. I even left home by 1 o'clock a.m.
You know, when you love a person, you must not do unnecessary. That's the mistake you have done. You have spoiled this woman. You did things that everybody was questioning you because of the love you had to this woman.
Yes, it's true.
But in return, she thought you are worshipping her.
Ash.
So that's why you are facing all this problem.
Ash.
Sometimes you speak, you just left you.
Yeah, it's true. It's like
and also you have fallen.
I've fallen to zero.
So now you're no longer having that. Because when she loved you, she was seeing you have 1, 2, 3.
Yes, yes, yes.
Now you don't have anything. What is she going to do? She must show you. And you've got many friends, you see. Mm. You've got too many friends. And these friends are the ones who are confessing you.
Yes.
And they are telling you, leave this man. And you are listening to them. So you must stand with your husband. You leave this man will prosper again. You don't need to love a person because of money. This money will come and go. You understand?
Yeah.
It will come and go. The way you are doing to this man wants to leave you today.
Yes, that's
true. He told himself that if I won't speak with him, it's over.
It's true. Mm.
That's what he told you.
Yeah.
I told her outside.
You told her outside?
Yeah.
So can you see that? You must really repent and humble yourself. This man did many things for you. He did many things, this man. He's tired. Many people, you see, now he's please lift him up. He's crying because he did a law. He did everything. And this lady, she's like this, the way she is. She's just like now you can see her husband is crying. You know, a true wife, when the husband cry, she will cry. It's not true. Yeah. But herself, you see the husband is crying. Just say. Even some people here are crying. You know, in relationship, if you find a woman loving you when you don't have anything, it's a right woman. Are you hearing me? If you find a woman loving you, the right state of searching for a wife is when you've got empty. So that when you are blessed, you'll be able to take everything to your wife. But look at this woman. Many friends. This woman is something else. She needs to ask forgiveness before God. So that these people who are attacking her, because there are people who are attacking her, they are calling this marriage useless. You understand? And then also there are brothers who are searching for her now. She can kneel down and ask forgiveness. God will restore her heart again of love. Do you want to ask God forgiveness?
Yes. Yes.
Mm. Because your husband is useless. You can make him useful again before God by kneeling down. You can kneel down and ask God forgiveness. Because no, you face your husband, you tell your husband. Don't kneel before God if you can't kneel before your husband. I'm sure you understand that.
Yes.
If you can't kneel before your husband, don't kneel before God. Because some of you kneel before a pastor, but you can't kneel before your husband. I mean, I don't understand people. Some of you call me daddy, but you can't call your husband daddy. When you reach home, your husband is James. You just say, "Hey, Jimmy." Even now, your children now. That's why some people, when you call me daddy, I feel like I can clap you. Because at home, even your father, you can't even call daddy, mama, your parent. You can't even say that. Your husband also is just, you just say, "Hey, Marcos, itamo." Even your child now. Look at your child. Well, kimanga rumile ki Marcos and your husband. What you are teaching your child is that child will grow up disrespecting you. The child will just grow up disrespecting you. You must never, I can't call my, you see, look at my wife there. I just make joke here and say Eunice. For me to say Eunice, I want you people to know her, her name. So that you must not call her Makwerekwere. Because already you call us Makwerekwere. But the truth is, I want her to know her name. You to know her name. You understand? But truly is, look what you're doing. How you disrespect your parents, your husband. And I can't call my wife. She can ask her. I call her, "Mama, where are you, Mama?" Woman, you can ask anybody here. She will call me daddy. No names. Let's respect one another. If you want to live long, respect those who are older than you. You are not doing it for them, you are doing it for God. So let's hear my sister. What are you saying, sister, to your husband? "This man, I don't want him to leave you, because you'll be surprised your friend is the one who will take over now." These people who are friends, they normally say, "Yeah, munna king. Especially in Nabatua Beggars Ford. Karka fellow Karini Shori, Aribere Kibbutz. Alright, let's hear, Ceci.
Ke re monaka ntshwarele ka diluka mgaje go direla go tsona.
Ceci.
Ntshwarele a ke sana go utela dilo ka gae. Cause ke a tsara ntho e kgopisha go re ke dira dilo tse dingwe ka thoko ke sa go botse ka magae. Ke ntho le gore ke a tsara ya go kgopisha. A ke sana go tlo go utela selo ntho engwe le nngwe ke tlo ba open mo wene ka go botsa. Ke gopela ntshwarele dilo tse ka moka ga tsona ke di dirileng. A go sane sephiri se e le gore ke sa tlo go direla sona go tloga le gona. Ke gopela ntshwarele.
My brother, lift your wife if you are forgiving her. Forgive your wife.
Man of God, I don't trust her anymore.
I didn't hear you.
I don't trust her anymore.
Why you say you don't trust her?
She did a lot and I asked her before. Before every secret can be revealed, I asked her before. She denied everything.
Remember, we are before God. She's before God now.
Amen.
And she's asking forgiveness before God. Amen. And it's God who convicts her heart. It's not you, it's not me. You understand?
Okay, man.
Yes. You need to forgive her.
All right.
She's your wife. It is true she has hated you. There's a lot. But you need to really forgive. It's your wife. Are you hearing that?
Amen.
Yes, yes. What are you saying?
I forgive him. In for.
Lift your wife. Lift your wife. You hug your wife. You kiss her. Hug your wife. Kiss your wife. So forgive your wife. If there's anything you can find from today, just say, "I've forgiven my wife. She has asked forgiveness." Are you hearing that?
Amen.
Welcome, my brother.
Welcome, my brother.
Because there's a lot of problems. There's a lot. Even your wife was tired. She wanted to leave you. So when you wanted to leave your wife, even your wife wanted to leave you. So now you people now, you exchange phone. You deal with these people who are entering your phone. who's supposed to make you to be separated so that you stand together.
Because
once we nyala msari, like this, there are many enemies who come to destroy the marriage. You can be surprised. Like when I'm a brother, your wife is not so much beautiful. But you'll be surprised people are searching for your wife. And you question why. My brother, you're not so handsome. But you'll be surprised. You'll be surprised the ladies are coming around you. I'm going my brother.
Amen.
Huh? So, are you hearing my sister? So now all these people who are coming around you, people cut them, all of them, you stand together, you carry on as a husband and a wife. You are going to enjoy marriage from today.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Congratulations. You can go back and sit down. Yeah. Let me say it directly. How do you feel, sister? How do you feel?
I am feeling fine, sir.
Huh? What about you?
I'm feeling fine, man of God, but there is another one that is left, like in a mine.
Huh?
We've got a business in a mine.
No, that's how you people from today, you are going to prosper.
Okay.
What Satan was doing was to separate you.
Okay.
So that you suspect each other.
Okay.
From there, they block everything. You're going to make it, all of you.
Amen.
And there is money that is coming to you.
There's money
that you're going to receive. When you receive it, come to me here so that I take some money from you.
I will do so.
And bless you.
I will do so.
Because God wants to make you a very big man.
Yes, because I used to do charity. It was.
I know your heart.
Okay.
You love people.
Mm.
You love to take care.
Yeah.
So you have not lost anything. There's money that is coming to you.
I understand.
You understand? And God wants to bless you in a very shocking way. I can see money coming.
I receive men of God.
God bless you. Mm. Yeah. You must know. Look at my wife there. Already. She's very old. Look at myself. But what Satan will do, normally he brings people to us. Look at myself, what more do I want? How can you say you want something in this age? But Satan will bring people. Even my wife, she will tell me that when she's walking in the mall like this, there will be this brother say, sorry, Ceci. I say, we're not Sally Ceci. Sally Ceci, we're not. So I thought, I even say one day she will go to the mall. Come shalom ra. Oh, Ceci, Ceci, sha! Oh, wonder if mom too. I'm sure you understand what I'm trying to say. I'm trying to show you a state where we are in. I mean, how can somebody come to me now and say, she loves me? How now, in this age? What is it that I want now from you? And what is that you want from me in this age? I mean, it shows that it's a temptation. So whatever Satan is bringing now is what? A temptation. So you must stand with your wife or stand with your husband. I believe you're going to do that. I believe you're going to do that.